accompanied by the Secretary of State and the Secretary of Defense.
Para el mortero 82,
this sight
soviética. is for a Soviet name and has been adapted to use within 81 order.
In the moment we see us, we want to talk.
We also have some medical supplies, a walkie-talkie. This is the type that we use most frequently.
Un vehículo que por accidente fue detenido en Honduras en diciembre de 1985.
We have a vehicle that was stopped in Honduras in 1985 after suffering an accident.
Pero estos son los vehículos que nosotros usábamos para hacer el transporte de armas, capturados a día a día,
tener
la importante información.
Una
mina antipersonal, de fabricación checoslovaca, que fueron encontradas en un corredor entre Nicaragua y Honduras.
These mines were found in a corridor between Nicaragua and Honduras.
Una guerra también conteniendo nombres en clave de Honduras.
Here's a code book that contains code names for different sites in Honduras.
Otro lanza cohetes RPG-2.
Here we have another RPG-2 rocket launcher.
Una clave cifrada.
A code notebook.
Y la granada rusa, que son las que nosotros más hemos usado en combate.
And the Russian grenades, which are the ones that we would use most commonly in combat.
Thank you, Mr. Merrill. This,
in my capacity as a former militant of the Nicaragua Liberation Front, and also as a former member of the Ministry of the Interior of my country.
A partir del día 26 de julio de 1979.
As of the 26th of July, 1979.
Cuba y Nicaragua definen una estrategia de superación.
Yeah.
En los primeros meses de 1981 se inician las primeras entregas de armamento a la guerrilla salvadoreña procedente de las armas recuperadas de la Guardia de Honduras. A Nicaragua, aviones de jet de pasajeros. Hecho a escala en Libia y han llegado a Nicaragua fletados con gran cantidad de armamento fabricado en países de la OTAN.
Also, we received planes that were given to Nicaragua.
Para llevar a cabo esta estrategia de superación latinoamericana, Nicaragua.
Charles Coxon was beaten by that one. Genevieve Bauer. A minister by the name of Willie Allen, an American minister. These are things that we live with this administration government. Yes, but all I can tell you that I think that we're getting ahead personally. The doctor came and told them, if you want to keep this man alive, you have to take him out from here. So that's why they come from where they happened. It had to be out in the earth. It couldn't be nowhere else. But they need one. A Cuban to testify, I said I already testified. I already told my story, and if you want to hear it again, I'll tell you again. I have nothing more to tell you. They carried me back to the Modelo jail. 10 days after, they set me free. They want me to work with them. After being in my hometown, one of the security for the FSLN came to me and he said, Archibald Zaripa, in a little tiny canoe dory with a paddle. That's how I reached the Costa Rica. 3 days.
Now I have the honor to introduce the President of the United States. Thank you very much, Vice President Bush, Secretary Abrams, and you, three gentlemen. Thank you for this eye-opening presentation. Thomas Jefferson understood escalating through to the public. Even some well-intentioned elected officials seem to be operating under outrageously false assumptions. These captured weapons, the vivid description of subversive activity, and the portrayal of repressive proof of sanctities to crimes against their neighbors and against the people of Nicaragua. These weapons and the test leave us in the process. These rifles, land mines, grenade launchers, and other weapons did not just miraculously run drugs to poison our children is backed by an extraordinary support network of international communists. One doesn't need to be of a particular party or even privy to secret information to see what's happening in Central America. It's clear, as a staging area for aggression against their neighbors while totally subjugating their own people, their campaign of internal repression and external aggression is being aided. Let's make no mistake, this nation too is threatened. If we do not act now to counter this subversive aggression by helping the brave men and women of the Nicaraguan democratic resistance, America's will in the not too distant future will be an irreparable disaster. And that's why I'm asking the Congress to set aside partisan politics and act now to protect our national security in Nicaragua. America needs to hear the testimony of individuals like the ones we have with us today, men who were on the inside, on the other side. Senor Romero was the former rebel commandant in El Salvador. Brutality, repression, and the shroud of lies in which the communists draped themselves. Senor Archibald, who was tortured in jail. These three are only a few of the many who deserve to be heard by decision makers. I would hope that all members of Congress, we have not had a chance to hear their message or have not seen this display, will take the time to do so. The display will be on Capitol Hill next week. What we heard from these brave men also confirmed the internal repression with a well-managed campaign of lies, distortion, and just as we've been told here, disinformation. The masters of deceit have outdone themselves, but Americans can and will see through this smokescreen. The communist goal is to paralyze us, prevent us from doing what is necessary to save Central America. But they will not succeed. Ultimately, in a free society, the truth will be heard. Today, I think we've got before us some facts.